There are times when we're writing programs that we need to get random data. When we're programming, we're writing AI, we need some sort of random data, a coin flip or whatever it is. And so there's some built-in tools, and it's interesting how they try to create different random algorithms to use the computer to create a random number. Well, can it ever be truly random? And the answer is probably not. If a machine's emulating a random number, then there's got to be some sort of process to it. And whenever there's a process, then that takes out some of the randomization, right? But they have worked out a number of different algorithms. And so there are different tools to create random numbers is what I'm getting at. It's not just one tool, random number. People have tried to come up with better and better algorithms that take out any sort of pattern in the random numbers. And one of those tools that works pretty well is a class in the util library called random. And so let's take a look at that quick. Random fun. This sounds like the title of a Facebook album or something. Random fun, bunch of pictures of me and my friends. Public static void main string args. And so just like we built the scanner class to read in information from the user, we can build a random class to generate random numbers. And so I need to import the java.util dot, but instead of scanner, we're going to use random. And this allows us to get random numbers. And to build an instance of this random number generator, I say random r equals new random. Now this name r, I can actually call it whatever I want to. I could call this, num generator. It doesn't matter. It's just a name I'm assigning to it for me to use. But what I've done here, again, is I've declared this is what it's going to be called, and then I say, now go build me a new one of those. When I bought the car I bought before the last one, I bought it from the dealership new, and they didn't have the one I wanted. I had some specifications that I wanted this and I wanted that, and they didn't have anything on the lot, and they didn't have anything they could trade for. And so I said, well, can I just order one? And so they said, yeah, that's fine. You can order one. It'll take 6 weeks. And I said, that's fine. So I ordered it. It took 6 weeks, and then they delivered it. And when I got into it, it had like 4 miles on it. And the guy told me it doesn't come with any less than that because they take it and run it around the track to make sure everything's okay. Anyway, I had them build me an instance of that particular make and model. I wanted one of those. And so I ordered it, I got it, and there were plenty of people who had the exact same make and model car I did, but they didn't have my car. My car was one instance of the make and model. And so we'll talk about this idea of object-oriented programming, but what we're doing here is we're saying I need one of those random number generators, which is a program that sits out in the Java library that we refer to as random. That's the name of the program. I say I want one of those, and I'm going to now give it a name. This one's mine. R. Now go actually and build it. And so this is where they build it, and it's set to be an instance of this R. Anyway, that's a little beyond where we needed to go with this, but I'm still trying to give you kind of the bigger picture of things, so that when we hit that part, it kind of hopefully makes more sense because it'll be the third or fourth time we talk about it. And so now that I've got this random number generator set up that I'm going to refer to as R, I can get a random number by saying int, let's get a number, and it's going to be equal to, well, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to set it equal to 0 initially because I don't want you to get confused on this point. This is where the random number has been declared. The name of it, right? And I've just set it equal to 0 to initialize it. Now I want to actually put a random number into it. And I do that by saying this. You know that number variable I set up? I want to take that and set it equal to R, which refers to my random number generator that I've just bought, air quotes. So R dot, and then what do I want to get? Well, I want to get an integer, so I say next int. This is kind of like the scanner, right? But instead of, with the scanner, we don't put anything in the parentheses. With the random number generator, we say what, out of how many? How many do we want the random number out of? And so I say I want a random number out of 10. Okay, so then after I get that random number, then I'll print that random number. So I'll print number. All right, so let me try. I'll save this and compile it and run it. Okay, so we've got here the number 8 is what came out. Okay, and if I run this again, there's a 9, 5, 3, 4, 0, 2, 2, 7, 0. Now notice when I'm getting these zeros, I thought I said I wanted a number out of 10, right? Well, in the computer world, we a lot of times will use zero-based numbering, meaning we start with zero. Zero is the first number. Usually when we have, you know, an apple on the table and we say count how many apples there are, we say there's one. But in the computer world, that apple would be apple zero. And then we'd have apple one and apple two and apple three, apple four, apple five, all the way up to apple nine. And that is 10 apples, right? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 is 10 numbers. And so what this random number generator is going to give us is a random number from 0 through 9. That's 10 numbers. Well, what if I want it to be through 1 through 10 instead? Should I change this to an 11? The problem is that'll give me a random number 0 through 10, so I'll still get zeros. That's not 1 through 10. And it's 11 numbers now because 0 through 10 is 11 numbers. All right, well, that's not going to work, so what do I do? Well, I can just take, once I have that random number, and add however much I want to onto it. So if I want to get 1 through 10, I can just add 1 to the number. I had 0 through 9, so after I get the random number, then I add 1 to it, and I get 1 through 10. Although a lot of times what I'll see is people will do this, add the 1 inside the parentheses. Well, all that does is have us get a number out, 0 through 10 again, so we still have that 0 option in there. There was a 10, a 10, a 6, and there's a 0. So now we're still dealing with 11 numbers because that's what we've told it. There's 11 numbers possible. And so if we want 1 through 10, we say, let's take that 10, get the 0 through 9, which is 10 numbers, and then after we're done with that, then we'll add 1 to it, which will give us a 1 through a 10. And there's a 10, and now we shouldn't get any zeros. We should only get 1 should be the lowest number, and there's a 1. And now we have a random number 1 through 10. What if we wanted it to be 100 to 110? Well, let's get a random number out of 10 and then add 100 to it. Now we'll get 100 through, 109, because we're getting 0. 0 plus 100 is 100. 0 through, 9 plus 100 is 109. But and so we'd need to, if we wanted to get a number, see, now I'm just getting confusing again. But the point is, I'm not going to continue with that example because I was going to say let's make it 11, but now this is completely ruining my example because this will give us a number 100 through 110, but that's 11 numbers, right? 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110. That's 11 different numbers. But the point is we can manipulate this. Once we have a random set of numbers, we can then by using the plus or the minus, turn it into whatever set of numbers we want to have. But the point is, this gives us a random number out of 10 different options. All right, so then we can use that to however many we need. If we need a random number out of 3, then we can get that. If we need a random number out of 100, then we can do that. This would be 1 through 100, right? And so the random number generator is very useful. We just have to keep in mind where it actually generates the random number is here. And so one of the problems that I see students do quite often is to say r.nextInst out of 100 here, and then now I'm going to go run my program. Well, the problem is if you're doing any sort of loop or anything, the random number is only generated once up here. It's not generated down the body of the code, and that's why I prefer to just default it to nothing, and then when I need the random number, to actually pop it in the code at whatever point I want to do that. All right? That's random numbers, and there are different options. This isn't the only one. I think we'll talk about at least one more in this series of videos, but that's one option for creating random numbers. Spencer out.